When this joyous occasion begins, I'd like everyone to take a moment to focus on the ceremony at hand, the stunning location, the love of family and friends that palpates the air, and the devotion that Leah and Taylor have to each other. I'd like you to gently close your eyes for just a moment and feel the sun upon your skin, the breeze in the air, the sounds of nature that surround us. God's presence is here today in all his splendor. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, love has been your richest and greatest gift to the world. Today we celebrate the love between Leah Marie Collier and Taylor James Waters. May your blessings be on this wedding service. Protect and guide and bless them and this gathering with your love now and always. Wedding day can be a blur of details with tremendous stress. Part of my advice to Leah and Taylor for this day was for them to work hard to be in the moment. I'd like them both to take a moment now and look around at this gathering of loved ones who have come to celebrate this special day. Shared their hopes and aspirations. Some of you have been with them forever, and others perhaps only a short time. However, together, you are the fabric that weaves one of the most precious entities in life. You are family. This union will mark the beginning of a new family, and Leah and Taylor invite each one of you here today to be a part of that extended family. In this ceremony, Leah and Taylor have decided to give a formal and public declaration of their love for each other, and you are included because of their love for you. You are here today to witness the joining of soulmates. For whatever our souls are made of, Leah's and Taylor's are the same, now and for eternity. Thank you all so very much for being here today. I now would ask for the mother of the bride and the parents of the groom to come forward. Taylor and Leah would like to thank them. Like the bridesmaids' lanterns symbolize keeping the light on for family, Patricia and Letitia and Larry each have a special lantern with a private note attached to honor them. Taylor is a gift to you from God, but he is not your gift alone. It is God's will that in your love, this man might find within himself a greater sense of who he is meant to be. You are asked to see the good in this man, to accept him for who he is and who he shall become. In this way, God's purpose shall be accomplished in this relationship. And so it is with you, Taylor, that although Leah is God's gift to you, she is not a gift intended for you alone. You are asked by God to so love this woman that in your love she might find herself as God has created her, so beautiful and strong and true, that the entire world might be blessed by the presence of this woman who shines so. May she know that from now on, there is one on whose love she can depend forever. She and Taylor will now read their vows, with Leah going first.
Taylor, I vow every day to make our foundation brighter. Thank you.
vow to be your foundation as you will always be mine. I vow to work hard every day to make you laugh and feel love. And I vow to always be your teammate, no matter what adversity life throws your way. I vow that while I'm not always patient, that I will do my best to always work hard.
Chosen to incorporate the lasso ritual into their wedding ceremony today. The lasso is a time-honored wedding ritual in which the couple are bound together with a ceremonial rosary. Lassoing is a declaration of intent where the bride and groom clearly state in the presence of this gathering and in the presence of God that they are marrying of their own free will with full awareness. I would like to ask the mother of the groom, Letitia, and the mother of the bride, Patricia, to please come forward. Let the union of binding together this rosary be an inspiration to your life. Remember the holiness necessary to preserve your family can only be obtained by mutual sacrifice of love. The rosary, symbolizing God, makes an infinity sign, which symbolizes eternity, while the figure eight shape it creates echoes new beginnings from the Bible. Taylor and Leah, the last song of the other's hands so that you may see the gift that they are to you. These are the hands of your best friend, young and strong and full of love for you, that are holding yours on your wedding day as you promise to love each other today, tomorrow, and forever. These are the hands that will work alongside yours as together you build your future with support and encouragement to chase your dreams. These are the hands that will passionately love you and cherish you through the years with the slightest touch, comfort you like no other. These are the hands that will countless times wipe the tears from your eyes, tears of sorrow and tears of joy. These are the hands that will tenderly hold your children. These are the hands that will give you strength when you need it. These are the hands that will lift your chin and brush your cheek as they raise your face to look into your eyes that are filled with overwhelming love for you. And lastly, these are the hands that, even when wrinkled and aged, will still be reaching for yours, still giving you the same unspoken tenderness with just a touch. Taylor, do you take Leah to be your lawful wedded wife? Promise to love and respect her, to share your life and your dreams, to build with her a home that is a place of love, happiness, commitment, and continued growth. Do you promise to be a companion to Leah in all her successes and failures, her happiness and sadness, support, and above all else, the freedom to be herself. Do you promise to love, adore, and encourage her? Share the good times and achievements, as well as the hard times and disappointments. Keep her in sickness and in sorrow and in health, and to be loyal to her forevermore.
I do.
Leo, do you take Taylor to be your lawful wedded husband? Do you promise to love and respect him, to share your life and your dreams, to build with him a home that is a place of love, happiness, commitment, and continued growth? Do you promise to be a companion to Taylor in all his successes and failures, his happiness and sadness, to always give to him your unwavering support, and above all else, the freedom to be himself?
I do.
Do you promise to love, adore, and encourage him? Share the good times and achievements as well as the hard times and disappointments. Keep him in sickness and in sorrow and in health, and to be loyal to him forevermore. A reading from the Book of Ruth. Entreat me not to leave thee, or to return from following after thee. For whither thou goest, I will go, and where thou lodgest, I will lodge. Thy people shall be my people, and thy God. Other a ring that has been warmed and blessed by your family and friends. And blessed by the Lord. This most precious of metals symbolizes the love that is the most precious element in your love, your life together. The ring has no beginning and no ending, which symbolizes that the love between you will never cease. You place these rings upon each other's fingers as a visible sign. Take this ring, place it on Taylor's left hand, and repeat after me. With this ring, I give you my heart.
With this ring, I give you my heart.
From this day forward,
from this day forward,
you shall not walk alone.
I shall not.
My heart will be your shelter. Take this ring, place it on Leah's left hand, and repeat after me. With this ring, I give you my heart.
With this ring, I give you my heart.
From this day forward,
from this day forward,
you shall not walk alone.
You shall not walk alone.
My heart will be your shelter.
My heart will be your shelter.
And my arms will be your home.
And my arms will be your home.
Marriage encompasses all of life's most important relationships. The wife and husband, each other's best friend, confidant, lover, teacher, and listener. Marriage deepens and enriches every facet of life. Taylor, in all the world, there is no heart for you like Leah's. And Leah, in all the world, there is no heart for you like Taylor's. May the peace of the Lord be with you. Having expressed their love and devotion for each other in this ceremony, today, in the presence of God, family, and friends, and by the power invested in me by the state of Colorado, it is my honor and privilege to declare you husband and wife. Taylor, you may kiss your bride. on the planet Earth, Mr. and Mrs. Taylor and Leah Waters.